And now for today's Bible question. Today we have been learning about Jesus' work of ministering to many people and how he spent quality time in prayer. We also learned about John the Baptist, God's servant who lived very simply and pointed attention towards Jesus rather than himself. Someone might ask the question, shouldn't we expect God's servants to be honored with more money, nice clothes, car, home, and the praise of people? Actually, when we look at how Jesus or John the Baptist lived among the people and served God, we will notice that they did not take comforts to themselves. Jesus never owned a home. At least we do not read of this in the scriptures. He did not carry about money with him, was often hungry and thirsty and weary physically from his constant labors as he moved about from village to village preaching and ministering to the people. John the Baptist is also a man who lived on the simplest of foods, eating wild honey and locust and dressing in crude camel's hair garments. He probably looked a bit rough in appearance, as he was not living in a palace, but staying in the wilderness. The main focus of their lives was to preach God's righteousness and salvation, and this meant that they did not look to make their personal circumstances prosperous or comfortable. Now it is good for us to honor those who serve God in faith by enabling them to carry out their good work, but we should not be expecting them to take all of their profits from preaching and build for themselves some little empire where the people gather to worship them rather than Jesus. Perhaps this sounds extreme, but in some churches the pastor seems to be exalted to such a high position above the people, and the congregation is completely captured by all his words. We must remember that anyone who serves the Lord is just a mere man, a sinner like the rest of us. We do a great injustice to the kingdom of God when we exalt men above measure, applauding and honoring them with overflowing praise, filling their pockets with earthly riches. To be honest, there are very few men who can handle such honor, praise, and riches, for these things tend to capture a man's heart and fill him with pride and false dependency. It would be refreshing today to see some men who serve God in a similar pattern to John the Baptist, choosing rather to live in poverty, separated from the world, and preaching righteousness and not preaching things that tickle the ears of their listeners. It is not wrong for a man of God to own a car or a house if these things are used to serve the people of God. All possessions and money should be thought of as belonging to the Lord and given to the man of God to aid him in his service for God, and not for personal indulgence or inflating pride. Too often, preachers and pastors are living far above the standards of the people they serve and are using their religious service to gain riches and luxury. This is clearly a violation of the principles which Jesus taught and lived before his disciples. May the Lord help us all to see the need to deny ourselves, take up our cross, and follow him. Our relationship with Christ is not intended to make us rich in this world, but rather rich in heaven. The sooner we can learn this, the more impact we can make for the gospel in our generation. Then said Jesus unto his disciples, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Matthew chapter 16, verse 24.